Hi, it's Paris from Epic Review Guys, and do you remember the days when everyone used to carry a checkbook, and some people were very clever, and in the inside plastic pockets they would put their driver's license, their credit card, their cash. They basically turned their checkbook into a wallet, except nobody carries around a checkbook anymore. But everyone carries around a cell phone, and the people who made the As Seen on TV phone pocket say this can become your new wallet.
Epic Review Guys.
The As Seen on TV phone pocket is pretty simple. It's a stretchy cloth fabric that has adhesive on one side. You stick it onto the back of your phone, and it's supposed to have enough room to slide in several credit cards they show in the picture, maybe your key and some cash. Maybe everything that you need. It only costs $5. I found it at our local As Seen on TV section of our drugstore. If you can't find it locally, I'll put a link down below this video. Now, I think it was sometime last year I reviewed a Kickstarter wallet. It was a wallet that was supposed to have everything you needed. It had a strap on the outside, a bungee cord kind of thing you could slide your phone in. So in that case, the wallet was carrying your phone. Also had a loop for putting your keys on. It became rather a large object to carry around. What they're trying to do here is take the phone that you're going to carry with you anyway, put with adhesive this device on the back of your phone, and it's supposed to be very thin and you can fit in it just what you need, and then this is all you have to carry around your pocket and you're set for the day. Here's the phone pocket out of the packaging. There really wasn't a whole lot in the package. You can see it's thin. This is 3M adhesive on the back. They have a little sample credit card here to show you how easy it is to slide things in. It feels smooth, like a very thin neoprene type material. And it is stretchable. So let's see if I can take with me out of my wallet what I need for my daily life. If your cell phone is too small or it's not a smartphone style, then this may not fit, but everybody's carrying gigantic phones these days, so I don't expect this will be a problem. It's pretty narrow. I think this would even fit on the iPhone 4S, but I didn't try that out. I'm just thinking it might. My phone is the Nexus 5 from Google, and it fits with plenty of space to spare. Now, the other thing to consider, of course, is the camera that's on the back, the light sensor, and you have to make sure you're not blocking your speakers. And I didn't see that it comes in different colors, just black, but that matches my phone. And they say that this comes off easily and that it's easy to take the adhesive off, otherwise I'm going to have permanent adhesive marks on my phone. What I go through for reviews. Okay. This phone is rounded on the edges, so you do have to make sure, too, it's in the center where it's completely flat. Because once you've committed your credit cards, cash, keys, and whatnot to this, you don't want it to fall off. Okay, it's on there. You can have a look at it, how much it adds when empty to the thickness of the phone. There's that neoprene-type material. Now, my PetSmart Pet Perks card is not actually something that I have to have with me all the time. I'm just using it to hide the other things. My actual driver's license. I also need to take with me a credit card, debit card, business credit card, the insurance cards, and the Office Depot rewards card. So the pet, I'll take one of them off then to make up for the thickness of the Pet Perks card that I'm adding here. Let me pull one up. Okay, so this is what I would be taking with me card-wise. Let me see if I can fit it in here. Now, of course, it needs to be usable. You need to be able to pull the things out fairly easily, too, at the store, unless you want to disassemble everything every time you need any of the cards. Well, it's snug. Wouldn't be that worried, at least when it's new, about the cards falling out. Okay, that's all the way in. Still got some more stretch left to it. If I need to pull out the top card, let's see. Yeah, that's not bad. Fits back in. Let me try to get one out of the middle. Let me see if I can see which card is which inside here. So I'm looking for like the third one, the credit card. Yeah. So far, so good, actually. Let's add some money. I actually have $11 today, which is more money than I have on a lot of days. This will not slide in with a single fold, so I'm afraid this is going to make it awfully fat folding it again, but let's see. Obviously, you have to take all of your paper bill notes out to pay for anything since they're all folded up. I like a folding wallet so I can keep the money easy to reach in and grab a bill and not have to pull it out and show everybody what you have, though with $11. I probably don't have to worry too much. Okay. Well, it's in far enough to be held in. I wouldn't keep coins in it, so that's not an issue. And I might have a keychain with a bunch of keys, so I couldn't put keys in it. So if I had to pay for something, okay, paid for something, gotta put my money away. That's doable. Okay. Let me try it in my pocket. Let me try to make a call with it. Definitely does, when it's full now, it does add some thickness to the phone. I have fairly big pockets here. Always put the screen side in. That's not bad. That's not really much different than having the phone. The other thing I noticed is when I put the phone down now, it doesn't go flat on the table, which is actually a good thing because I always hated doing that, worried about scratching up the lens of the camera. Now, about making a call. Let's pretend. Well, obviously this part's still the same. It doesn't interfere with the way that I hold it. Now, the wallet I'm currently using, the Allette, which I really like, it's the world's thinnest wallet, but it's got stringy things all coming off and holes in the corners now. I've had this several years. These are great wallets. And I'm about ready to order another one. I'm wondering though whether I should give this one a try. I like this actually. One concern that's occurred to me though is it's holding those credit cards right against the phone, and that's day in, day out. Is it possible that the cards could get demagnetized from being pressed right up basically against where the battery is in the phone? I don't think so, because I know the phone produces a lot of RF energy, radio frequency, but I don't know that it produces much electromagnetic energy. It must produce some. Well, I did a quick Google search on cell phones demagnetizing credit cards, and actually it seems unlikely. As I thought, most of the energy here is the radio frequency energy that won't affect the credit card. The part that could is the magnet for the speaker, which is the earpiece up here, and I think this phone also has the speaker at the very bottom. So there are little magnets here and here, but it's not likely that the cell phone will be able to demagnetize a credit card. So if that's the case, I may actually give this a try, at least for a few days, and see how it works out as a replacement wallet to my Allette. So I'll report back in a few days or a week's time, let you know if I'm still using this, whether it worked out for me or not. Again, if you're interested in it, I got it for about $5. If you can't find it locally, there's a link down below this video.
Shopping is easy when you